And welcome, everybody here in Twitch chat and everybody on YouTube, for some Tianna Watcher. This isn't going to be your normal Watcher deck with Shadow Isles and all the fading memories and all that kind of stuff. We are going to be playing a little bit more of a straight-up Watcher deck. We'll still have Lissandra, we'll still have Trundle, we'll still have our removal spells ramp and things like that. But then we're going to be going into Demacia, where we're going to have Tianna Crown Guard be able to rally. We're going to have Captain Erika with the Spell Shield. These are both 8-cost units, plus Uzgar, another good 8-cost unit. And all we're going to need like these 8-cost units to be able to help out as far as leveling up the Lissandra, creating the Watcher. And then whenever we create the Watcher, of course, we need 4 of them to be able to put the Watcher into play. Now, what if we don't have the ability to put 4 of the 8 plus cost allies into play for the Watcher? Well, we are also going to be playing Revitalizing Roar, where if we are enlightened, Revitalizing Roar can like make that Watcher cost 0, and then we can play the Watcher for 0 mana. It could surprise some people with that. They may not be expecting it if we have a Watcher in hand and it's like their turn currently and we just have 7 mana. They're not going to be expecting it to come into play. But we Revitalizing Roar, make it cost 0, play it for 0, and then go to our turn and open attack. That could surprise them. Let's see. In order to get enlightened, we're gonna have 2 Voices of the Old Ones that give us 2 empty mana gems. That's gonna get us enlightened much faster. So besides our 4 regular ramp spells of 3 Catalyst, 1 Cold Resistance, we're also gonna have the 2 Voices, so to help get us enlightened super fast for Revitalizing Roar. All right, but let's give it a try. Cataclysm could be really cool. Also, like how we could play Watcher whenever we usually don't have the attack token, and then we could Cataclysm. So that could be kind of cool of like get that free attack, surprise them. I don't know. Maybe it'll work. Maybe it won't. Who knows? We'll go play our 5 games in ranked, and let's see how we do with Tianna Watcher. All right, Draven Ezreal. Smetcherita, what's your question? You say you can't put code after finished deck. Thanks. I'm not sure which. I don't know what the question is. Like here's a link to the deck list right here that you can click on it, and there's a button to copy the code from there. I'm not sure exactly what the question is. Okay, Draven Ezreal, they're going to be using removal spells on our cheap stuff. We certainly want ramp. I think we keep an avalanche in case they have the house spiders and stuff like that. No, we don't even keep that, so we can draw another one. So let's look for some ramp. Unfortunately, no ramp spells for us. Yeah, we could definitely use one right here. Safety disengaged. Nope.
Prime and ready. Join me if you want to live.
Okay, we'll go ahead and do 2 damage to these with the avalanche. Not quite 3, but we can ice shard now this turn to make it 3. So trade 2 for 2. They get the different created cards. We'll start the Frozen Thrall countdown.
Can you improve perfection?
It's 8 turns till we get a Frostguard Thrall.
Safety disengaged. This is gonna be fun.
Do not embarrass me, troll.
So I was mulliganing looking for the ramp cards. Did not find any, especially Catalyst of Aeons. Fortunately, they didn't let me untap and have Fury of the North available. There's Catalyst. So if I do play Catalyst, which I will, I don't get to block, which that's fine. I don't know about this Judgment in here. This Judgment looks a little off. Alright, hoping to draw an 8 plus, like an 8 cost unit. They can play Ice Pillar, then play the 8 cost unit. Believe in the Judgment. Well, we kind of have a lot of our, like, little spells that look kind of silly.
Nothing escapes my watch.
They're gonna be using Scorched Earth on it, that's my guess. Same thing. This is why we need this Frostguard Thrall showing up with this thing. Four more turns.
Join me if you want to live.
Lissandra is definitely our best draw from here. So if I draw Lissandra, I can actually play... Yeah, their life's pretty good. I can play the Watcher the next turn. Wow, we did it. Wow, we really did it. We really did it.
A ticket to the gun show.
More than mortal, I am Iceborn.
I told you Judgment would carry this game. I'm not sure it was the Judgment. I don't know about that. So they can still have Arachnoid Sentry. Most of these decks play Arachnoid Sentry to stun. So it's not a guaranteed win right now, because they could stun it and then also deal damage to it and then like Noxious Guillotine or whatever.
The world's a big place. Let's see all of it.
Yeah, Of course, we'd also have Cataclysm next turn. We're back up to 20 with a tough Nexus. Alright, so now we're definitely good, right? They don't have two mana stun, do they? All right, so it looks like Judgment hard carried for us. Yes, they could have a second Ezreal. All right, cool. Because even though they'd have a second Ezreal, it's just like we're back up to 20 health and like that's their last card in their deck and it's like, how do they kill us? GG's. Okay, so let's see how we do against Thresh Nasus. See if we can get that Judgment to hard carry us again. It definitely wasn't the super lucky top deck Lissandra. The one that it was definitely... yeah, we mulligan cold resistance, right? It was definitely the Judgment. So I don't know about the Flash Freeze. I was thinking about keeping Flash Freeze because of Nasus, but that's probably like a long ways into the future. Probably don't need... I guess I should probably be mulliganing the Flash Freeze as well. Lissandra would have been great with that cold resistance. I would have kept the cold resistance. Alright, very glad I didn't play the Lissandra, because they would have killed Lissandra with the Sand Spinner. Tavern Keeper was still a 3-3, the Judgment would be looking a little bit better. All right, good. No Black Spear. I was worried about that.
It's good to be the king.
Yeah, this is a good Captain Erika matchup.
I'll knock him dead.
It's gonna be 9-6.
The trolls are going to war!
With... ages pass, but I am eternal. Embrace the cold.
Sweet. Pass.
Do as I command.
Have them waste a bunch of mana. Why are you vulnerable? Oh, Sand Spinner. Sand Spinner gotcha.
Roll, I don't think.
Levels up Thresh if I do that.
Foolish child.
Let's be down to 5. Y'all think they're riding negations incoming? What do y'all want the riding negation to do? Oh, y'all wanted me to do judgment? Yeah, I'm just playing some 8 drops.
Embrace the calm. I cannot recover all that is lost, but I will try.
But I will try. I don't know, Aishar doesn't really do anything. There's a Ride of Negation. Got that out of their hand.
Oh, fresh soil.
Okay, so we definitely know that their plan is to simply play another Thresh. Definitely looks like their plan. Yeah, I guess I do have the cool Cataclysm play. I guess I could have done that. That's maybe cooler than the Lissandra play. Yeah, I guess that would have been the cooler play, wouldn't it? Because yeah, that was their plan. So like, that was, they were gonna try to put a Thresh back into their deck, but I would have Cataclysmed and then ate it up afterwards. Yeah, what if they would have had a random crumble?
What do you think, Puff?
Oh. What would you have thought about a random crumble? What are you saying? Is it time for the stream to be over already? But we're only in our third deck? Yeah, we're playing some slow decks today. Brr. Puppy's doing her Watcher impression.
Ooh, look, I'm the Watcher. I'm too big and scary.
Okay, what do we got? Lucian Azir. I could see maybe keeping the Revitalizing Roar, but probably not. Yeah, Lucian Azir is definitely going to be a difficult matchup for us, especially like how they have rallies and can attack multiple times. This is a bad pairing. Oh, that would have been a good, that's a good call. Belladonna, like my previous opponent did play the Unspeakable Horror, and they could have gotten Moonlight Affliction off Unspeakable Horror for the Watcher. I didn't even think of that, but yeah, that's, that could have been their plan. Wow. You're just gonna sit here real nice?
My name will echo through the ages.
Gonna watch us play?
All things grow cold.
So Lissandra blocks Sand Soldier as well, because Lissandra has Tough, and Sand Soldiers have one power, so those work out pretty well together. See, now you're learning. Teach my puppy how to play Runeterra. don't teach Puppy how to play Runeterra, because he's going to start spamming Thresh Nasus, because sees Nasus as the doggo. You wouldn't do that, right? You wouldn't just start spamming Thresh Nasus, right? Alright, got a Shapestone out of their hand. Cool. It's a terrible mana trade for us, but what else are we doing with Fury of the North? We have some weird looking cards in here. Fury of the North, Concerted Strike. But who knows? Maybe they will help us win games.
Stand down.
You stand down. Oh, yeah. Puppy would probably play Celestial Doggos.
name echoes through every rock, every canyon.
Can you really echo through rocks? Don't you echo off of rocks, not through rocks? I'm confused by this, Azir.
Do not embarrass me, troll.
Cool. I'll have them waste their 5 mana. That sounds good to me.
To the streets! Show them the might of our army!
Shows of power excite the people and quell our enemies.
You always ask for so much, Azir. Like, 3 things on the to-do list. I am always very scared of this Inspiring Marshal. I have learned to be very scared of Inspiring Marshal.
You will do as I command.
Nothing's tougher than a troll.
So I don't think they had another Shape Stone, but I could see them having another Sharp Sight, so that's why I blocked, have Trundle blocked over there. Alright, so next turn's gonna be turn 7, so we'd have 7 plus 2. Yeah, might as well display the Sentry.
They're out there. I'll spot them.
Yep.
Azir's blessings!
They look angry!
Sunlight!
Light the signal fire!
Yeah, I could have blocked with Lissandra, and Lissandra would be alive, but Lissandra would only be at 1, and so therefore Lissandra would die to the Blighted Ravines. Because I figured I was playing Blighted Ravine this turn. I don't really want to just pass and let them open attack. They're doing that, of course, to level up Azir.
What you have seen today.
Yeah, the rallies are really good against these slow decks that don't block very well. The rallies were definitely really scary, and so they had 2 rallies. The first rally we survived, the second one. Second one's gonna be pretty tough. The Sharpsight did nothing. Are you kidding me? It killed my Lissandra. That Sharpsight just won the game. Like, without that Sharpsight, our Lissandra's still a 2-3. We, like, block over here. We can still have Lissandra block again. we can even go, like, we can't win now possible. We're dead. Like, we wouldn't necessarily be dead to open attack next turn, right?
Foolish child.
No, I guess we would be. Yeah, never mind. I guess we would be. Either way.
You cannot fight the code.
I was thinking, like, maybe we could get, like, the like the champion spell in Tomb. But it doesn't matter. Why wouldn't the 2-1 attack? If the 2-1 attacked, I would just be dead right now, but... We're still dead.
Destiny calls.
Yeah, the double rally got us. Well, that plus the... Basically all the combat spells, right? If they have one less of any of those combat spells, maybe not the sharp side. The sharp side we're dead by that point anyway, but they don't have like that +3/+1, like that really messed me up. The give the 4/6 tough, so my concerted strike didn't kill the 4/6, that really messed me up. And then both rallies really messed me up. Awesome, DJ. Thank you. Thank you, thank you. Yep, tough matchup. We knew that going in. Said that at the beginning of the game. It's a tough matchup for us. Rally is great against slow deal 2 to everything removal, right? Like those kind of removal spells, like Rally is great against that when you're not blocking. All right, let's see how we are against Deep. Yeah, your cards like Avalanche, Ravine, all those are not good against Rally. Like when you, right, against like decks with Rally, you need like units to block, you need like units to keep trading, and then the Rallies don't really do anything. But if you're just using spells for removal, the Rallies can dominate. So I was thinking Lissandra on 3, Cold Resistance on 4, Voices on 5, and then we start dropping 8 drops on 6. Looks like we could do that whole plan without Lissandra. We can do Catalyst on 3, Voices on 4. A couple of sea monsters tossed plus atrocity. These decks usually just play like one atrocity. Oh, right, we can't go voices on 4. What am I thinking? Yeah, so there, some people do play 2, or yeah, you said you saw 1 with 3. Some people do play more atrocities. It's not common, but it's a thing. Does the judgment get revealed to the opponent that we drew judgment? Do they know about this judgment right now from voices? You know, it says draw each card that costs 8 plus. But does that get revealed to the opponent of like, okay, now they know exactly what card it is?
Hmm.
Okay, no. Alright. Chat saying no.
Can see the Demacian border from here.
Alright, they're going deep next turn.
I will bury the world in ice.
Doesn't look like they're giving me an opportunity to judgment. I think they're going devour here, and that's gonna mess me up. I hope they don't. I hope they play something else. Okay, cool. Not devour.
I shall lead the way. I will remind the world of true power. Embrace the calm.
Bow to your king!
No hesitation.
Do I want Tianna to attack? Probably.
This is gonna be fun.
So they have 10 cards in hand.
You will do as I command.
Sweet.
Break bone for Troll King Thrall.
Burn a Maokai. Ways away from
onward to victory.
Crack ice and flesh.
Still a little ways from playing this watcher. good. I like seeing devourers get burned for good. Yeah, I mean, I guess that happens.
Feeding time.
Nothing escapes my watch. Crows survive.
Yeah, I mean, they're worried about the tough Nexus, I suppose. They had two more Abyssal Eyes? The Stalking Shadows? Or I guess it may have just one extra. They played the non-ephemeral already.
Danger paid.
We have two Judgments in our deck? That's crazy. They have five Abyssal Eyes, it's even more crazy. Alright, so we shall see if they have... I mean, all they have to have is just another Nautilus in hand, and they break this up. Like, we should not be playing two Atrocities. Or, sorry, two Judgments. Judgment is so easy. Like, so we kind of learned the other day, we played a Sivir Judgment deck, and every time we played Judgment, we lost the game. It's kind of too easy to break up.
Ready the torches!
But with the cards in hand, I don't have any other choice. And like with how this game is, I don't have any other choice but to try. Alright, going for glory for Demacia. I hope they try Atrocity. No. All right, Judgment's kind of the worst card in our deck. But, oh well. Yeah, because all they needed was Nautilus's Champion spell or Vengeance. Yeah, we had to just hope that they would play Atrocity. I mean, they could also be thinking about Harsh Winds, Carver, but... Yeah. Maybe that's what they're thinking of. It's like Harsh Winds as far as attacking with just the elusives. Yeah, Judgment unfortunately never works. So we're in like a, you know, Ride of Negation metagame. Everybody has Ride of Negation or Frostbite. If it was another 8 drop, we could have played Watcher, but you know they were holding the Vengeance for the Watcher. Draven, Ezreal. We'll have Lissandra, we'll have double ramp. Kinda need to keep all these cards. This metagame is just really, really ready for Judgment because everybody's trying to beat Nasus and Atrocity. And both those, like all the cards that people play against those things are great against Judgment.
A dark cloud looms on the horizon.
And of course the Nasus Atrocity deck has the Ride of Negations.
Everything's easier behind a mask.
So it's a little rough. But oh well. We're having fun. We're 2-2.
Follow my lead. Shatter. Time for a true display of skill.
All right, we'll get some more mana.
Witness perfection, meat legs. System upgrade.
I've had enough of you.
Unfortunately, their hand was really aggressive and hurting our very, very greedy hand. I know they kill us if we have another burn spell. I could play Catalyst to try to stay alive, but if they have another burn spell with Ballistic Bot and everything, like, we're not just staying. Like, this game's over. It's not like I'm killing them and they have. Like, that game's just over. Yeah, I've got to play to win. You know, like, got to play to win, not play not to lose. The only way we can win that is they don't have any other burn spells and we get to Trundle get like the 8 drop started. So, I mean, I think there is some decent stuff here with like the 8 drops and with rallying and everything with, and, you know, revitalizing roar and stuff like that. We had some cards that, you know, honestly, this just isn't a good judgment metagame. You know, we joked about it the first game because we got to win without judgment. But I wouldn't recommend playing Judgment. I wouldn't really recommend playing Concerted Strike. We saw like that cost us a game too, of not, you know, trying to, you know, like whenever we Concerted Striked against the, like, we were looking okay against the Lucian Azir deck, and then we tried to Concerted Strike and they had the one mana give their thing tough that just canceled out my Concerted Strike, and then that hurt us. So I would recommend some more early stuff, right? Like, you know, our curve is really, really high. And I think that at least like the Lucian Azir matchup, maybe we could have won, and maybe some others that if we had some earlier stuff. Yeah, cold resistance. If we have, I'm okay with cold resistance, but we kind of need more units early, right? Like we only have Lissandra early, you know, a guest Tavern Keeper or Sentry, but you know, like we need some other earlier units for that. So like a deck like this, I could see a deck like this even playing cards like Egghead Researcher that can just be like a decent blocker early that gives you like dragon followers that maybe you hit like the 8 mana dragons. I could see playing a card like that. I do think that single combat would be better than Judgment or Concerted Strike. I think I'd rather have single combat. I know that it's basically only for Trundle or the expensive stuff, but it's easier to play that expensive stuff and then have single combat as another spell than Concerted Strike or Judgment. It just costs too much mana. So I think I'd want other cheaper stuff like that, like single combat, Egghead Researcher. We could probably just go a little bit more into Demacia and have some more defensive stuff like that early. So yeah, Troll Chant's always an option if you want Troll Chant. I don't think I like Blighted Ravine. I think I'd rather, like, yeah, I think I'd want the third Avalanche over the first Blighted Ravine. Fury of the North can go. Fury of the North's not necessary. Yeah, and then probably some Troll Chance, right? Yeah, probably just Troll Chance over some of these other cards to help protect Lissandra, help Lissandra block. I think that makes a lot of sense. But this was a cool deck. Different, you know, different deck here. Started off well with the first couple of wins. So there we go. That's Tianna Watcher. You know, could use some tune and everything, but, you know, we tried going big. Tried going big, and, you know, sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't. Those of y'all watching later on YouTube, hit that like button over there, and of course, as always, feel free to leave those comments as well. Let me know what you think of the Tianna Watcher deck, or just any of the new cards or anything else. Always love seeing those comments. But thank you so much for watching some Tianna Watcher, and I will see you for the next video.